You know, the seabirds tell us a lot about the health of the ocean, and so we tap into their knowledge, to their physiological capabilities, and how they make their living, and that tells us a lot about the fish that are out there, about climate change that's affecting the fish. And so we're using the birds as indicators or messengers of what's happening in the ocean. You know, the best way to get any predictability about what's going to happen to our fishery is to look as far down on the food web as you can go. When we check the gannet parental feeds, if the gannets are bringing back mackerel for their young, then we expect the commercial fishery for mackerel to be strong. If the gannets didn't get mackerel, Newfoundland fishermen didn't get mackerel. If the gannets didn't get squid, Newfoundland fishermen didn't get squid. Then that's the correlation that we've had over like decades. What the gannets do for those species will tell us what the commercial fishery is going to be like. And I mean, we study seabirds, we love seabirds, you know, but the thing is, we're studying seabirds to figure out about the ocean. We're really studying them as ocean messengers. So that's what, I mean, the birds are telling us things about conservation, about precautionary tactics that we could take, that policymakers and decision makers, you know, here's some evidence-based information about, you know, how it's affecting other animals in the food web, how it's affecting seabirds. Well, we should do something about it.